Thank you. Thank you. one more time. Give us just a minute to put everything back.
Thank you. Thank you very much for being here tonight. It's a little bit confusing when we have as many ensembles as we have to perform, and sometimes it seems like we're moving furniture more than we're performing. Sorry about that, but that's just the nature of the beast, I guess, in a very active school music program. Part of what we do when we teach music, especially in the wind ensemble, is I try to make connections for the students, either historical connections, cultural connections. We tell them that all music either sings or dances, and some of it does both, but music also speaks to us of particular times and places. And I want to talk about just a little of that with the three pieces that we're about to play for you, the first three. Overture in B-flat was composed and published, anyway, for band in 1966. That's about 50 years ago. And I gave it out on the day that was the 50th anniversary of the first broadcast of Star Trek. I didn't intend to program it. I was just going to read it with them and show them some things about how the music from the Star Trek theme relates to this music. Band music at the time was starting to really explore a different type of tonality. Instead of the do-mi-so tonality of the major chord, quartal harmony, fourths. If I can have a clarinet play a C, an F, and a G below the C. Middle C, G below, F. Not the same kinds of harmony we hear. But the Star Trek theme was very much into that. And this piece was very much that way as well. You're going to hear some of the same elements that you hear in the old, wonderful, classic Star Trek theme in this. And so the time and place takes us back to the mid-60s and the place, the final frontier.
Thank you.
Tommaso Albinoni was an Italian composer several centuries ago, and some of his works exist in their entirety. The next piece we're going to play for you did not. A musicologist, somebody who studies music, found a scrap of paper, a fragment of one of Albinoni's works. It may have been a completed piece that just got lost. It may have been an idea he was working on and he never completed. Well, the work was completed and now scored for band. You're going to hear the Italian in it. You're going to hear themes that could very easily be from an Italian movie 50, 60, 70 years ago. Something totally different than the overture in B flat. Here's Tommaso's Adagio.
Thank you.
Jacques Offenbach was a French composer. Light opera, comic opera, pieces for the cabarets, the nightclubs of Paris, the early to mid 1800s. His most famous work, most well known to the general public, is probably the Can-Can. We don't have any dancing girls tonight. But the Gallop is similar in context to the Can-Can. It's a dance scene from his opera, Geneviève du Brabant. Jennifer from someplace. What's unique about this piece is it's also probably the first time the theme that became the Marine's hymn is heard. Now, whether or not it was taken directly from this, influenced by this, or it was totally an accident, nobody knows. But listen, because you're going to hear what is almost the Marine's hymn a little later in the piece. So the time, 1830s Paris. The place, Paris, all the way to the halls of Montezuma. Thank you.
grateful for them, for all that they have done. The parents and the families want to offer to each of you a small token of our appreciation and show you how much we really care for all of you.
Thank you very much. It is truly a pleasure to teach in a community like Brentwood. This is the 26th December concert I've conducted on, I think, unless we missed one along the way, and I don't think we have. And every one of them has been just a little bit different. It's been a thrill to be here with you tonight. The last piece needs no introduction. ¶¶